My name is Ed Boon. I'm the project lead for Mortal Kombat Armageddon, which comes out October 2006 for the PlayStation 2 and Xbox. We're really trying to wrap up the whole Mortal Kombat story because this is the last Mortal Kombat on this generation of consoles. So we're really trying to end a lot of things, end the story, end the whole feature set, and everything in terms of like the new, everything you know about Mortal Kombat, we're kind of ending with this one right here. You know, for future Mortal Kombats, we're going to have a completely wipe the slate clean. We're going to have, you know, brand new characters and all that stuff. So this is really kind of like the culmination of all the Mortal Kombats. Armageddon is going to contain every Mortal Kombat character from MK1 all the way to Deception. So all the boss characters that you've seen before, Goro, Motaro, Shao Kahn, everybody that, you know, a lot of characters you couldn't play as before are now playable characters in the game. Yeah, well, in addition to having every Mortal Kombat character, we thought like the next obvious thing is to let players create their own characters. And we've really taken that whole create a character idea a lot further than other fighting games have, because we've really taken letting you obviously name your character, define the character's look, but also define the character's fighting style, name the character's fighting style, and select every animation for each button. So it's a very intricate create a character feature. And what's really cool about it is we also let the players take their character online to see how they fight against other characters that people from across the country might have created. Fatalities in all the previous Mortal Kombat games have been a very passive thing. You do the button combination and then you watch the show. And in Armageddon, a fatality is really just kind of broken up into a bunch of mini fatalities. So every character is a whole bunch of fatalities that he can perform, but then the order of which you fire them off is up to you. So we can, like, you know, tear the guy's heart out, then tear his ribs out, and then break his neck, and then tear his head off in any sort of combination that you want. So it's a lot more of a, like, a custom fatality than we've seen in any previous Mortal Kombat. Yeah, Conquest Mode has taken some very big leaps forward in terms of graphics and gameplay. You know, the player can not only just run around and interact with the NPCs, but they can also get into fights. So it's you get into fights with like multiple enemies, and it has its own fighting mechanic. You know, so there's weapons you can pick up, cut up all a bunch of enemies at the same time, and also with the story progression, it lets you interact with them, unlock hidden secrets, and all of the kind of single-player features that we've had in the previous Conquest mode. All the Mortal Kombat games that were 2D, there was a lot of emphasis on, you know, combat in the air. So you can actually jump in the air, jump over fireballs, jump over your opponent and try to kind of confuse them there. And when we went to 3D, everything was kind of, you know, leveled down onto the ground. And we've reinstated kind of that whole 2D element of it. So you jump around kind of like you did in Mortal Kombat 1 and 2. But then you can also do combos in the air, parries in the air, breakers in the air. Anything that you could do on the ground, you could basically do in the air. And that really kind of opens up the whole fighting mechanic to be a lot more unpredictable than the previous Mortal Kombat game. Okay, the name of the game is Mortal Kombat Armageddon. Coming out for the PlayStation 2 and the Xbox in October of 2006.